bullying. You suck.
Ha! Game!
Man, you aren't good at anything, are you? Jeez, you go home. Give me your lunch money.
I'm sorry.
Bullies. What are they? Why are they? Who are they? What are they? How are they? Bullies generally are people who find life hard, so they want to share their pain with others. In a sense, bullying is an outlet, not an electric outlet. But you can't compare it that way. I will try my best to. Bullies get their power by dominating school, bullying people, messing with them, taking their money, and feeding off of their fear. Almost like, in a sense, a TV, camera, computer, and fan would feed off of a regular outlet by using its power. And the power sources are unlimited. That's why bullies do it. Bullies will bully siblings. They will bully animals. They will bully anyone they can, anyone they can feed off of, because they know they can get away with it. Bullies are generally males because of the fact that growing up as a guy, you know, expressing your feelings came easier for me as I was younger, but the more and more I experienced stuff and more the world became masculine around me as it enveloped as I grew up as a maturity slash maybe even puberty thing, it's even harder to express your feelings as much as you'd like to try to. And, like, it really took a lot out of me to actually get me to fully cry for once. The last time I cried, if I remember correctly, was 5th grade. That was because my mom had breast cancer, which she survived, by the way. But it was hard to deal with, and as a 5th grader, obviously I'm going to cry because I don't know what's going on. I think in my mind she's going to survive because that's what I'm supposed to think, and that's what media society is telling me, but there's that slim chance that she may or may not survive. She did. And after that, though, I hadn't cried again until senior year, and that was twice. Once because a good friend of mine from kindergarten passed away, and another because of a senior seminar, and my dog also passed away the same year, and the dog that I had since kindergarten as well, kindergarten, first grade. And basically all my problems just boiled on down to those two incidences, and I had my outlets because I had friends and I had family and stuff like that to always guide me through, but bullies don't always have that. Bullies generally are lonely and they don't associate themselves with people because they have a feeling that no one else understands them, which is very sad, which is why you should always make friends and you should never close a door on a friendship, in my opinion. That's what my mom told me, and I keep that dear and dear to my heart because I have made friends with all kinds of people, people that have been to Judy for a few weeks that have slipped up. I've made friends with people that smoke weed all the time, people that play video games, that are in all kinds of sports, that are scholars, that are models, that are people that go to the club all the time. And as I digress, all in all, bullies don't just bully because they're feeling pain. There's obviously some reason behind it. Bullies wouldn't pick on a random student if they didn't have a reason to, because I wouldn't bring my 3-prong outlet to a 2-prong because it, A, wouldn't fit, and B, it would be extremely hard to get power from it because you don't understand how it works and you do not understand it, which is why a random person wouldn't just attack me. For all he knows, I could attack him and bring him down even worse. Which is why bullies try to find a way to attack you through economic status, gender, size, race, and even, most importantly, sexuality, which has happened more and more. I will give you some sociological concepts through this book called In Conflict and Order, Understanding Society, so we can, too, all of us, learn to understand how a bully works and why it works. Have you ever been bullied? Chances are, bullying happens to a lot of people, even bullies. If a bully bullies one person, then chances are, if one kid in the class bullies, there's a class of 30 people, and one bully bullies someone else, there's 28 kids plus a teacher that sees it happen, So that kid's sad, and that kid's friends that sit around him attack the bully, and then the other kids gossip. So considerably, in a sense, a bully has the most bullies, because even though people say the phrase "sticks and stones might break my bones, but words will never hurt me," trust me, you can punch someone, but the punch and the bruise will only, that pain will only last so long. But if you were to actually, if they were to find out the reason why you punched them, then chances are the reason why you punched them would stay in their mind a lot longer than a bruise on the skin. Because you can beat someone up and send them to a hospital for 6 months, but you can tell someone off and tell them they're ugly, disgusting, disturbing, and that will send them to a mental hospital for 2 years at least. Words can go a long way. Which is why bullies use brutal words, because they know that they don't have the strength to tell someone everything that's wrong about them. They would rather beat them up, they would rather just bully them in the simplest way they can, because they're being attacked verbally. It's a mind over matter. Sad.
From a sociological standpoint, I'm going to talk about the behavioral trends, the effects, and the solutions of bullying itself. So I'm going to read an excerpt, and it says, behavioral trends. Bullies who routinely intimidate and hurt victims are often referred to as serial bullies. As a social group, they share a set of tendencies, characteristics, behaviors, which are demonstrated over time. Bullies tell lies habitually to achieve certain results. And they are experts at appearing innocent in the presence of everyone but their victims. Bullies often neglect their homework and other responsibilities, and they are very proficient at getting what they want from others. And they keenly absorb social molds and functions to enable themselves to fit in and escape blame. Again, I'm pretty sure many of you can reference that to any movie or any bully that you've seen. I mean, part of it says they tell lies habitually to achieve certain results, and they are experts at appearing innocent in the presence of everyone but their victims. So, part of that can relate to, for those of you who have seen the first Spider-Man, Tobey Maguire, or Spider-Man, gets in a fight with one of the bullies in the hallway, and the bully's the one that's picking the fight with Spider-Man, when in fact, he's the innocent one, or Peter Parker's the innocent one, when in fact, he is the innocent one, but then, like, at the very end of the whole thing, Peter Parker gets in trouble because he is the one that's just defending himself, and when in the return, at the very end, the bully is the one that's in the wrong. That's just one example among many. The effects of bullying. Long-term bullying can have a number of detrimental effects that last for years, even decades after youngsters are perpetrators or subjects of the abuse. Victims tend to skip out of school and individual classes to avoid their predators. Up to 160,000 kids are absent from school each day due to their fear, according to Dr. William Pollock, a noted expert on the subject of school bullies. Suicide also has been reported on the part of victims. Bullies are likely to remain violent as young adults. In his research, Dr. Dan O'Bruce notes that 60% of boys who bullied during middle school are convicted of a crime by the time they reach the age of 24. Which is sad because, well, if it's family problems at home, you're going to have to live with your family, or you're forced to until 18, and the problems reach out until you're 24 years old. So you could be an adult that has a working job, or you're in college, and you could still do things that can get you in trouble, and you could even go to jail by the age of 24, which is sad. So those are just some of the effects of bullying. And then now, lastly, the solutions are, in an effort to address the widespread social ill that stems from bullying behavior, many schools have established anti-bullying groups comprised of students and teachers. Courses are taught by administrators, community groups, and non-profit organizations to raise awareness of the problem. Since suicide and criminal convictions are very real considerations, it is important to make the issue less of a hidden shame and more of an open discussion of practices. Which I touched upon earlier because I said that there is stuff on media, the Trevor Project, there's stuff, bullying is on Cartoon Network, Nickelodeon, it's even on TV shows. I'm pretty sure I watched TV shows back when I was a kid, where all they talked about, each show at least had one or two episodes on bullying or bullies in general. Like, Hey Arnold had Helga, Doug had that green guy, Aang has Prince Zuko, if you want to even go as that far. But yeah, bullying is becoming a problem that's less and less now. It's being stopped, so that's good. Thank you, sociologists like myself, or an aspiring sociologist. So yeah, persistence. Well, I was rudely cut off by this damn camera. I'm talking to you. If I had hair, I'd flip it, but I don't, so whatever. Anyway, persistence. If a bully is persistently, constantly going after you because he knows that he can go after you because his parents go after him because he's an easy target and you're an easy target, and I know I'm talking fast, so bear with me, then you have to be consistent as well, which means you have to go to an adult, you have to go to a teacher, and you can get him just as he gets you. Please believe in me. I believe in you. Video and informal message on bullying. Okay, I will read the first paragraph here, and then I'm gonna cover a few points, and we should be good to go. Devious. First, the prefix is DVI, which DEVI, sorry. And it's like devil. Dev. Dark. Scared of it. It's just the social norms of
number four. Deviant is an integral part of our society. Always gonna be someone that has to stray the law. For example, anonymous. You might think that anonymous is the bully. That's a mark of disgrace or infamy. Basically, bullies are stigmatized because nobody wants to be rude, mean, dirty, stank-faced Rambo. That's just, no. Nobody wants to be hated and disgusting and shamed upon because basically everything bullies are doing is what's shamed upon nowadays. Especially with our whole Trevor project, which I'll get to later. Everything that I see on TV now, every other commercial, it's about bullying and stopping and help thy neighbor, love thy neighbor. So if a bully is going against what society and what media is telling you to, then you know something's wrong. It's an ethical problem that needs to be dealt with, and sometimes you can't stop it, sometimes you can't control it, but you have to live with it regardless. And hopefully this informative video gave you more of an insight as to why a bully might bully you. To touch back up on the whole stability thing, or cooperation rather, I only talked about size, which isn't good because not everyone's chubby. I'm gonna quickly go over your economic status, your gender, your race, your sexuality. If a bully is bullying you because of your economic status, like say you're either really rich or you're really poor, you can say it's not the fact that I'm poor, I'm just using my money wisely. And my family's saving up for me to get a car to go to a good college, unlike you. Or if you're really rich, well, I don't see why a bully would make fun of you because of that. You have money. Throw it in his face. As a matter of fact, offer the bully some money. See what he says. Don't let him take it from you. Offer it to him. Actually, as a matter of fact, don't bring any money with you just except for $1 and offer him that. And keep offering it to him and see how he does, and see how he likes it. See how he likes being embarrassed. That humility that'll get in his face. The whole fact of, oh, you want a dollar peasant? Well, you got one. You want more where that came from? Just give him that nice sass. You gotta do this, and you gotta act like a femme fatale and just go, shame on you, you know? You gotta get into his mind. You gotta take over. Next, gender. The bully bullies you because, oh, you're a boy and you don't know play sports, or, oh, you're a girl and you do play sports. If you're a girl and you play sports, go ahead. Kick a soccer ball at his head. And then tell the PE teacher it was an accident because you're such a good shot that you meant to shoot the dumbest, the hardest rock around so you hit his head. Try it. Next, it's race. If a bully bullies you because of race, then get in his face about it. Tell him, if he talks about you, especially if you're like darker like me, or you're Hispanic and you're a little bit lighter, or a little bit darker than him, then tell him, oh, I have more melanin in my skin. I have more flavor. I'm sexier, and once you go black, you can't go back. Tell him that. Tell him everything you can and mess with him. You know, don't conform to him. Adhere to yourself. You gotta just mess with him. Give him some biological melanin explanation about it to make him Google it. If the bully's a smart guy, wants to pick on you, then you have to just tell him that you're sexier and you're tasteful and people of color are beautiful and we actually have color ourselves. But for the most part, you just want to make sure you can get to him, you know? Don't let the fact that you're a certain race or a certain color get to him. And that is all. I had this whole thing set out as perfect. I was recording for a very long time, and then I realized that the damn camera wasn't even on. Mode. Before I pick up that book again, wherever I threw it because I was mad, I'm going to go into complete rant mode. And this is going to tie into bullying because it talks about the Trevor Project. ignore my ratchet claps, please. The Trevor Project is a project that was started by, if I'm correct, a homosexual man in regards to bullying and people getting bullied mostly about their sexuality. Well, their phrase, their slogan, they're everywhere, it says it gets better. Now, I would like to ask you, what exactly is it that gets better? Is it the fact that you can't lose weight? Is it the fact that you're gay? Is it the fact that your parents fight, you have a crack in the roof, your dog has a bad condition, you can't beat level 5 in Mega Man? Is it the fact that you're growing too fast and your parents can't afford to buy you new clothes so you look like you're a giant? Or Paul Bunyan? What is it? And that's the thing that's bothering to many people, is the fact that they keep saying it gets better, but we don't know what it is. You can pray and pray and pray that the bully leaves you alone, but chances are the bully will not leave you alone until you do something about it. It is not it that gets better, it is you that gets better. You are the one that can run outside, exercise, and lose all the weight. You are the one that can save up money and buy your own clothes if you're growing out of them. You are the one that can possibly put a bag over your house or fix the roof yourself if you need to, if it's bothering you that much. You are the one that can take your dog to the vet and slowly pay it off, slowly but steadily, and get it healed. And if your parents are fighting, you are the one that can call the police and interject, and you can solve problems. It's a slow start, and I know it's very hard, but trust me, you can do it. I grew up being a black, bisexual male in a white society. I had to get around it some way. I've been single my entire life. I haven't been in a relationship. Many of my friends have. I've lost friends. Family members. I've lost lots of people. But I didn't believe in this it. I didn't have a man named Trevor. All I had was myself. I made my friends, I made relationships with my family better, and I became who I was because I believed in me. Now, friend, it's time you did too. I have faith in you. We all do.
Yeah.